Into sports, Rob DeMello.
How's it going, everybody? Left with a bad taste in their mouth following a season-opening loss at Southern California 2 weeks ago. University of Hawaii football team hit Hawaiian Airlines Field at Aloha Stadium tonight, then proceeded to hit FCS member Lamar for Hawaii's first win of 2012. Victory in Halawa marked as the first for rookie head coach Norm Chow, and his Warriors were dominant in the milestone win. Offensively, junior quarterback Sean Schroeder worked the playbook, going 15 of 23 for 150 yards passing and three touchdowns, hitting Trevor Davis, Darius Bright, and Chris Gant for six. Running game added 219 yards to sign the offense out at 369 total yards. On defense, men in black were bullies, holding Lamar to just 127 yards of total offense, recording three sacks with three turnovers. And on special teams, two touchdowns, the first a blocked punt by John Hardy Tuliau, recovered by Naquan Phillips for 21 yards. Then to open the second half, Mike Edwards' 96-yard kickoff return for touchdown, the first since Ryan Mouton in 2008. Warriors run away to the win column 54-2, the final.
You know, I think we played a very complete game tonight. Offense, defense, special teams, you know, we had all phases of the game and we were pushing. So I think it was a good night and a good home opening.
Part of history, Norm Chow, maybe perhaps the first of many wins. Of course, you guys must be happy to get that W for him.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, we were in the locker room earlier and he got the team ball. Schroeder gave him the team ball as the first head coach, first win as a head coach. So yeah, we're really excited for him and obviously you know, the entire program to get going the right direction and hopefully keep stacking them.
Only points Lamar scored came off a botched extra point snap return for a score. Running back Joey Iosefa, who had 55 yards rushing, left the game in the third quarter with an ankle injury. No word on the severity just yet. UH now 1-1, moving to 11-0 since 2001 against non-FBS members. Now up next for the Warriors, Mountain West Conference opener against former WAC mate Nevada. Wolfpack today beat Northwestern State 45-34. Kickoff next Saturday, set for 4:30 at Aloha Stadium. To the prep level now, where only one team in the ScoringLive.com power rankings hit the field tonight, as number 2 Farrington remained undefeated with a win over McKinley at Roosevelt. Tyler Taumua and Abe Silva combined for 180 yards rushing in the win. 26-7 the final. Farrington has next week off before facing number 1 Kahuku on September 29th. Back to college football now, where 20th-ranked Notre Dame upset number 10 Michigan State in East Lansing tonight. And Fighting Irish middle linebacker Punahou alum Manti Te'o played phenomenally with a heavy heart after the passing of his maternal grandmother on Tuesday. Then just one day later, he lost his girlfriend, who lost her battle to leukemia. Team captain posted a team-high 12 tackles with one fumble recovery tonight, leading the Irish to a dominating 20-3 victory.
I mean, they were with me, you know, so, I mean, I couldn't do without them. I couldn't do without the support of my family and my girlfriend's family, and I'm so grateful for, you know, all the love and the support that all the fans, both Michigan State and Notre Dame, and, you know, fans around the world for, you know, just supporting me and my family and my girlfriend's family, and I miss them. I miss them, but I know that I'll see them again one day.
Unimaginable emotion out of the 21-year-old again, 20-3 the final on offense. Manti's best friend and Buff and Blue classmate Robbie Toma hauled in 5 catches for 58 yards. Irish now 3-0 for the first time in 10 years. Over to the Golden State now, where there's a major shakeup pending in the top 25 as 21st-ranked Stanford stunned number 2 Southern California tonight at the Farm in Palo Alto. Running back Stephon Taylor, 216 total yards with one score, and quarterback Josh Nunes threw for 214 yards and two touchdowns. 21-14 the final. Cardinal have now beaten the Trojans 4 straight times. Sticking with the Pac-12 now, where St. Louis graduate, 4th-ranked Oregon freshman quarterback Marcus Mariota led his Ducks to a 3-0 start with a win over Tennessee Tech today. First play from scrimmage, Mariota connected with Kamehameha alum, fellow Frosh, tight end Koa Ka'ai for the big man's first career catch. He finished with 2 receptions for 18 yards. As for Mariota, he'd check out by going 21 of 28 for 307 yards passing, 4 touchdowns and 1 interception. U of O wins big, 63-14 the final. And back here at home, round two of the three-day Champions Tour Pacific Links Hawaii Championship took place at Kapolei Golf Course, where seven-time PGA winner Bill Glasson took over top spot. Fresno native carded a -565 Saturday, moving to 13 under par. 52-year-old looking to earn his first ever Champions Tour win holds a four-swing lead over a two-way tie for second. As for the five Hawaii guys, Kevin Hayashi continues to lead the pack. He's at -2 in a tie for 28th. And Punahou alum Michelle Wee tied for 17th in the Women's British Open after two rounds of play there.